It is Wednesday, November 28th. Glad you're with us. I'm Susan Hendricks, and we start with this. The FDA just approved a groundbreaking new cancer drug that will treat cancer based on the genetic makeup of tumors rather than where the disease originates in the body. It's called Vitrakvi. It comes in an easy-to-take capsule or liquid form, too. It also comes with a high price tag. The pill's going to cost nearly $394,000 a year. You heard right. While a pediatric syrup version runs about $11,000. I'm guessing that's based on the dose. While the drug does not work for all patients, doctors say some patients, including children, have seen remarkable results. Dr. David Spigel, the director of the Lung Cancer Research Program at Sarah Cannon Research Institute, joins me. Doctor, good to see you. So how is this changing the way we view cancer? To me, no matter the price tag, it sounds groundbreaking in terms of finding exactly where the cancer begins. Is that what it targets?
You know, Susan, it really is groundbreaking. It's the second of its kind where the FDA has said, we don't care what kind of cancer it is, we care what's making that cancer tick. And this is a therapy that turns off that switch that's driving that cancer. It's called the NTRK fusion, a little bit of a complicated term, but essentially it's a switch that causes these cancers to grow. And this is a therapy that turns that switch off.
So if it's FDA approved, doctor, does it necessarily mean that insurance companies are going to cover this and follow suit, let's say if it does work?
Well, the therapy is really substantial in terms of how it benefits both, as you say, children and adults. And so with FDA approval, usually all insurance carriers will cover this, Medicare, of course, Medicaid, and then this is usually picked up by third-party payers. So we expect that to happen.
And the clinical trial, as I understand, the group was relatively small, just 55 people, including children. So how would someone know if this type of treatment may work for them? Do they have to be willing to test it on themselves?
Well, it's a great question. It was actually a collection of about three studies that included adults and children, about 150 patients total. But you're correct. It's a variety of different kinds of cancers that can occur in children and adults. It's not very common if you look across the spectrum of different kinds of cancers. Maybe one in 100 would have this different alteration. If you look within specific cancers, like say some sarcomas in children, it's actually quite common. So I think the lesson here is we don't know where it's going to be, so you should test patients who have cancers to look for this because we now have a substantial therapy to help those patients.
Which is great to hear. Dr. David Spigel, thank you.